Hello, precious family. I hope you're all healthy and well, together with your families. It is time to pray. But before we go into prayers, I would like to share God's word with you briefly. As I thought about what I will be sharing with you, I felt it's time that we are reintroduced to God as Father. I'm not sure when you'll be watching this, but to put it into context, it is the Wednesday after Father's Day in 2020. It is also a time in the world, and especially in South Africa, when our men, our fathers, our sons, our brothers are not painted in good light because of the issue of gender-based violence. Children are missing their fathers, either because they are dead, they are absent, or they are abusive. It is a very sober time in the history of humanity, a time when the word father may cause fear in our hearts rather than comfort. As I thought about prayer, I was led to the portion of scripture in Matthew chapter 6, where the disciples said to Jesus, "Teach us how to pray." I believe they had seen Jesus pray a few times, and they must have seen something attractive about Jesus, either during or after prayer. They must have seen something which they liked in Jesus, and they associated this thing. Could have been his calmness, his peacefulness, or his gentleness. They associated this with prayer. They wanted this for themselves, so they asked Jesus to teach them how to experience this thing for themselves. Prayer makes a difference in our well-being and how we do life daily. The time you spend praying influences your relationships and your demeanor with the people around you. Anyway, then Jesus said, "When you pray, say, 'Our Father who is in heaven.'" Wow, this is powerful. You see, Jesus wanted them to know that prayer is directed to someone and it has a destination. It's like writing a letter or an email. It must be addressed properly to the right person at the correct address. Otherwise, it cannot be delivered. So Jesus gives them the name of the one to pray to and his location. Although you may ask, why Father? Why not friend? Yeshua, Jehovah, anything but Father. I believe there is a significance to the choice of the word Father. For starters, our Father says that Jesus wanted to identify himself with God and with us. He wanted to say that there is someone who we belong to. He wanted us to know that we are not orphans. God made us and God wants us. He also located this Father to avoid any confusion about who we are talking about. Let me give an example. In Polokwane, South Africa, there are many Mr. Makwarelas. I know at least four. But if I wanted to be specific about the one I am speaking about, I would say maybe Mr. Makwarela in Bendo, Mr. Makwarela who lives in Stair Park, or Mr. Makwarela who lives in Fauna Park. That way, you know exactly who I am talking about. I could even get more personal by telling you where he works, the names of his children, and maybe even their ages. So Jesus says, "Our Father in heaven." You see, it is only after you have identified the receiver and his address that you can be personal with this person. You cannot ask me, "How is your husband and your children?" if you don't know whether I'm married or have children. The better you know me, the more personal you can get with me. You see, the word Father is a powerful word. It is an important word not to be taken lightly. It is linked with honor, authority, presence, provision, forgiveness, role modeling, direction, protection, and belonging. How do I know? Well, let us read the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. It speaks about honor. There is no name like this name. Your kingdom come speaks about authority. You have a kingdom that you rule over. Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. It speaks about presence. God is present in heaven, but he's also present on earth. And if his will is done in heaven, There is a culture, there is a system that God has in place, and we want that to happen in our lives. Give us this day our daily bread. It speaks about provision. Forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. It speaks about forgiveness, the fact that God is willing to forgive us for our sins and also teaches us and shows us how to forgive the people who sin against us. Lead us speaks about direction, not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. That speaks about protection. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. This speaks about ownership, speaks about abundance, permanence, consistency, and the fact that God is unchanging. When you hear or think about the word Father, what emotions do you feel? Do you feel safe or scared? Do you feel like you are wanted or rejected? You see, your interpretation of the word Father will determine the rest of the conversation. Jesus wanted to reset our picture of a Father when he taught us how to pray. He wanted to show us that we all have a Father to run to for guidance, for provision, and protection. He wanted us to know that we have a Father who is always present and never changing. And that to avoid all confusion and unnecessary disappointment, he located this Father as the one who is in heaven. Unless we have a true relationship with this Father in heaven, our interpretation of the word Father is limited to our experiences with our earthly fathers. And for so many, this picture is not always a pleasant one. Today we will pray differently because we will need to reset our view of Father. We will need to correctly identify the one we pray to, and then we can get real with him. We need to change it from the man upstairs to daddy, to baba, to papa, to the warmest word in your heart for Father. Let us pray. Father, we thank you because you are our Father in heaven. We thank you that we belong to you. We thank you that we are not orphans, but we are your own. Father, we hallow your name. We honor your name. We thank you that your kingdom comes in our lives. We honor you because your ways are not our ways. We honor you because you are in control. Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Lord, we pray for your presence in our lives every day. We submit ourselves to your plan, to your culture, to your system of how our lives should operate. We submit ourselves to your purpose. Give us this day our daily bread. Father, we thank you for your daily provision. We thank you because our needs are important to you. And we bring all these needs to you, Lord Jesus, because we know that you care for us. Forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Father, we confess that we are not always the children that you expect us to be. We confess that we sin against you, and we pray for your forgiveness. We pray that you will help us to forgive those who have sinned against us. We pray, Lord Jesus, for healing in our relationships. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Father, we thank you that your Holy Spirit leads us in all the decisions that we need to make. We pray for strength to not fall into temptation. We pray for protection for ourselves and the most vulnerable people in our society. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Thank you, Lord, because you are unchanging. Thank you, Lord, because you are abundant in your nature. Thank you, Lord, because your love for us is consistent. And Father, we worship you because you are who you are. We thank you for all of this. In Jesus' name, amen.